So to kick off the new year, I'm going to be doing a brand new build using AMD's Ryzen 1800X CPU, and we're going to be pairing that with a lovely 32 gigabytes of G-Skills FlareX 2400 megahertz DDR4 RAM at CL15 timings, and then we're going to stick those inside of the MSI Tomahawk B350 motherboard. The reason why I chose this one is it's nice and cheap, and it also has PCI and PCIe slots on there, so my old MRH16 audio interface, I can use my PCI card for the FireWire adapter. And then obviously with Ryzen you don't get coolers, so I'm just going to be using a Corsair H60, which is a nice safe bet. Now, I'm not going to sit here for ages and put together a really snazzy looking build video, but what I will do is give you a quick unboxing montage. That'll do. So after putting everything in the case, mounting the cooler, plugging it all in, the first problem I ran into was actually one of my DIMM kits was faulty, one of the RAM sticks, so I had to get that replaced, which is why it took me slightly longer to do this video. But before I did any benchmarks, I made sure I did the door bench test on the old i7-4770 rig, and so I could compare the results to the Ryzen build to see what the differences are. So here we go. Here's the results. So first up is the i7-4770 bench test, and for this project I'm actually running Cubase in its 64-bit engine, the brand new engine, and the project settings are at 44.1K at 24-bit. Now the reason why I went for 64-bit over the 32-bit is because I really wanted to push the CPU so I could see the differences between the Ryzen and the old i7. So looking at the chart here, you can see it didn't perform that well with the Rexacomp test. Now I could manage to run 121 instances at a latency settings of 64 on the buffer, and then opening it all the way up to 2048, I managed to get up to 133 instances before the playback of the project was just completely capped out and rubbish. Next up, we have the results from the AMD Ryzen 1800X versus the old i7-4770. Now, it's important to note that the Ryzen on this rig, I'm actually using 32 gigabytes of RAM, but with this particular test, RAM doesn't really make a great deal of difference in the figures because it's more CPU based. So, as you can see clearly straight away, the Ryzen's got a major advantage over the old i7 with pretty much two times the performance. Interestingly, with Ryzen, when you get to lower latency settings, it tends to lose a little bit more performance. And I would assume that if you were comparing it with something like Intel's 8700K Coffee Lake CPU, it's not going to perform as well because the single core performance is not going to be quite on par. But when it comes to the multi-core, it's really quite nice. And you notice when you get past a certain buffer setting, it starts to open up and you can do a lot more with Ryzen. So with this final test, what I wanted to do was compare the differences in performance across higher sample rates with Ryzen. So the original results at 44.1K, you can see in the green. And then what I did was ran the test again, but this time the session was at 96K. And you can quite clearly see the big difference here at the higher sample rates. It does tend to drop off quite a bit. At a buffer setting of 64, it only managed to handle 68 instances of Rexacomp playing with the session before it started hitting its bottlenecks and getting audio dropouts and the rest of it, compared to 317 instances running at 44.1K. So if you're a professional and you work at 96K or you work at the highest possible audio settings, then you might want to think twice about maybe getting Ryzen for doing that kind of work. But for the everyday consumer, this chip, it's freaking amazing. I mean, I know these results make it look a bit iffy, but honestly, you're going to be so satisfied with the performance. So how does this all translate to real world performance when you're working in your sessions? Well, put it this way, on my old i7, I would be able to run a maximum of 77 instances of Kontakt, all of the instances playing some form of MIDI data at the same time, and that would be it. You know, I wouldn't be able to get any more than that without my CPU bottlenecking or just the computer not being able to handle the playback. Now, compare that to the Ryzen. At a buffer setting of 512, I could get 153 instances of Kontakt playing different things all at the same time using different sample libraries. And then when I up that to 1024, I could then get 229 instances of Kontakt playing different MIDI data from different libraries at the same time, which is a lot more than I'm used to, put it that way. And then if you maxed out the buffer settings at 2024, I could just about get 308 instances playing MIDI data all at the same time. Now, there would be some audio dropouts, and there might be a bit of, you know, when you're sort of navigating through the session, a bit of lag and whatnot, but it worked. It would play back, and I was quite shocked by this. So if you load a massive template up, providing that you're not using all of, you know, every single instance you got loaded, because some composers like to make these huge frigging templates which are like thousands of patches in size, and to me it makes no sense because it can be a bit disorganized chaos. But if you're working in that way, then you could probably get away with doing it somewhat using Ryzen. You'd be better off going with an i7 though. But generally speaking, if you're going to be having templates that are thousands and thousands of patches in size with loads of instances of Kontakt and whatnot, then you're going to be using a master slave setup where you've got a separate computer hooked up to your master computer, you know, helping run your projects, and that's real high end kind of stuff. But for the everyday consumer, I think this type of performance is more than enough on the Ryzen 1800X. I mean, for me, definitely when it comes to audio production, this is the most power I've ever had. But when it comes to other things with the 1800, like video editing, 3D rendering, graphics, and all the rest of it, it is absolutely monstrous. It really is. My encoding times have dropped, my rendering times have dropped dramatically. Instead of me waiting like half hour, 40 minutes to an hour for something to be done, it gets it done in 5 minutes, literally, you know, big projects done in 5 minutes. So for the price with Ryzen, I would say it's a very good buy, especially for the average consumer, the amateur composer. You know, for the price, you can put together a Ryzen rig. You can't really go wrong.